Once you have released your first package, you can then enable the project and start setting your project settings. So in the settings, you'll currently find two tabs, General and Stream. Let's start with the General settings. In here, we have the button to enable or disable your stream. Turning it off will prevent the project from creating streaming costs. The project name is a friendly name under which your project will be available. Setting a proper name can be helpful in communication with Arcware support, although no one will see the name except for you and the admins. The Unreal Engine version. Here you can select which version of Unreal Engine the project was built with, and it also tells the WebRTC player which settings to use. Display resolution. This is the maximum resolution supported and being used by the WebRTC player. Currently we limit the resolution to Full HD, but if you need higher resolutions then you can contact Arcware support for that. The touch capability. You can enable this option if you have correctly configured your project to use touch in Unreal Engine. There will be a separate video covering how to set up touch events in Unreal Engine in our Preparing Unreal Engine for Cloud IT video series. Again, the link will be in the description for that. And then we have mouse lock. This is to be used when you want to lock the mouse inside your stream window. This also hides the mouse cursor from the browser and means you cannot click the external UI until you press the escape button to free up the mouse. There are also two hidden settings which are enabled by default for all users. The first is the dynamic resolution. So this setting allows your Unreal Engine application to adapt to any resolution or aspect ratio. If you would like your project to be shown in fixed aspect ratios, however, then you can contact Arcware support to disable the setting for you. Additionally, for the dynamic resolution to work, Unreal Engine needs to be configured properly. This is also covered in the Preparing Unreal Engine for Cloud IT video series. And the second hidden setting is called autoplay, which is enabled by default for all users. The autoplay determines whether or not the user is required to press a play button first to activate the stream, or if the stream automatically plays when it's loaded. So now let's go to the stream settings. In here we have maximum streams. This is the maximum number of concurrent streams you're willing to sustain and to pay. The maximum number is dependent on your chosen subscription plan. It is possible to contact Arcware sales to establish a custom plan and therefore guarantee availability of a higher number of concurrent streams. There is also a hidden option here for so-called pre-warmed streams, meaning streams that are already running in the background to remove waiting times when connecting. By default, there are no pre-warmed streams unless requested by you, as they produce running costs even when they're not being used. So if you would like to increase the number, please also contact Arcware sales. Then we have the reconnection threshold. This is a threshold on how long a stream instance is kept alive to allow possible reconnection. For example, if you lose internet connection or you refresh the page, then you'll return to the same session as long as it's in that waiting period. Then we have the maximum instance runtime. This is the maximum time an instance of your stream can run in total before it gets automatically disconnected. It should be noted that this feature has priority over the AFK timeout. Then we have the Overwrite AFK module. If you aren't familiar with the terminology AFK, it means away from keyboard. The AFK module is part of the Arcware WebRTC player, used to automatically disconnect inactive streams. Enable this setting if you want to overwrite the standard timeout values used for the AFK module. So here we have the option to enable timeouts. If the Override AFK module is enabled, you can then specify values for each of the following steps of the timeout process. The Warn timeout is the countdown until the AFK message appears in the stream. The Error timeout is the countdown until the error event message appears after the AFK warning. Then the action timeout is the countdown until the stream session will be ended. This will come after the error event. So also please note these timeout warning messages are not visible with the project preview in the platform or with the share ID link. They're only visible when you're using a custom built frontend. Also please don't forget that the maximum instance runtime will overrule the AFK module, meaning that if the max runtime is 10 seconds and the AFK module activates after 12 seconds, then you would never actually see the AFK because the max instant runtime would happen sooner. So that concludes the lessons regarding project settings, and I'll see you in the next lesson.